Hi friends, welcome to Taming Python series. In this video, we're going to talk about how to format the access tick labels using the tick formatters in Matplotlib. There are many tick formatters which are very useful. We're going to visit them one after the other. The first tick formatter we're going to talk about is the str method formatter. So basically it's string method formatter. For an str method formatter, you give the string format as an input and the labels will be as per the string format which you give. Here in my example, my string format was 0.02f, that means tick labels will be two decimals. So that's why instead of 1234, I got 1.00, 2.00, 3.00. You can vary whatever the string format you want and it will be as per your requirement here. So let's take a demo of this str method formatter. So first I'm going to take a blank folder. I'm going to open it with VS Code. I'm going to create a new file. I'll just name it index.py. So first I'm going to import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Then I'm going to import matplotlib as mpl, and then I'm going to take some values of x and y from this example. So these are x and y values. So I got my x coordinates and y coordinates as an example. Let's try without formatters first and plot the plot. So I'll just write figure comma axis handles equal to plt dot subplots, and now on this axis handle I'm going to plot x and y. So these are the x coordinates and y coordinates being plotted, and at the end I'll just write plt dot show so that I can show you the plot. So now let's try to save it and run this. Here you can see I got 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the automatic formatter which is done by Matplotlib. If I want to override this and show two decimals, I can use string formatter. So let's try to do that now. So I'm going to write ax dot x axis dot set major formatter. And in the major formatter, I'm going to write mpl dot ticker dot str method formatter, and here I'm going to do the format. The format string is really simple. Yes, you have to write between the two inverted commas, you just write the brackets, and here write x colon and write the string format here. So my string format is I want to basically show two decimals, so I'll just write 0.2f. that means if the number is even one, you have to write 1.00, something like that. So if I just save it and run this, you can see I was able to plot the x-axis labels using the string formatter, and in the string formatter I said it was 0.2f, that means I have to show two decimals. That's why instead of one, Matplotlib is showing 1.00. So this way, using str method formatter of matplotlib.ticker, you can give format string and format your tick labels as per your control. So if you give another format string, something like hashtag, and I say only zero decimals, that means it should be shown as a whole number. So let us see how it looks like. Here you can see hashtag 0, hashtag 1, hashtag 2, hashtag 3. So I'm able to format the tick label as per my custom requirement here. So using format strings, mpl.ticker.str method formatter is a really useful string formatter for tick labels. The next format we're going to talk about is the function formatter, which is a func formatter. So using the func formatter, you can supply a function that takes in the value and returns the string. So this is really useful when you have a custom and some complicated logic of converting your tick labels values into some string. Suppose in my example, my values of x-axis are 0, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. So if I want to show them in k notation, like if I want 0, 10k, 20k, 30k, something like that. So how can I do that is basically I can create a function formatter here and I can use it with plt.func formatter. It's really easy to use. So let's get started with this. I'm going to copy this x and y values in my example. So if I just copy paste here, and as usual, I'm going to take the figure axis handle and plot the x and y values here. So let's try and plot without the function formatter and let's see how the output looks like. In my output, you can see my x-axis labels are 0, 10,000, 20,000 and so on. So if I want it to be shown like 0, 10k, 20k, 30k, what I can do is basically I can create a function formatter and use that to format my tick labels. So let us create a function first, which takes in the values of the tick labels. Writing a function is really simple. You just write def and write 1000 formatters. You can write any name. I'm writing 1000 formatter. And here for the func formatter, you will have two values as an input. First one is the value of the tick label, and second one is the position of the tick label. For our example, for the conversion of tick values to thousands, you don't need the positions. I'm going to use the value itself. So I'll just write return, and here x by 1000. I'm going to take the value of the tick label and convert it to k notation. Like if it is 10,000, I'm going to divide it by 1000, then I will get 10 and I'll return 10k. So I'm going to use this thousands formatter function as a func formatter input. So how can I do that is, I'm going to do ax dot x axis dot set major formatter, and here I'm going to supply plt dot func formatter, and here I'm going to give the formatter as thousands formatter. So what I'm doing is, I'm setting the major formatter as func formatter, and the function I'm going to supply here is a thousands formatter. So what it does is, it's going to send the values of the tick labels. In my case, it's like 0, 10,000, 20,000. And those tick labels will be formatted as per my function return value. Here in my function, I'm going to divide it by 1000, and I'm going to attach k at the side. So that you will get, for 10,000, you will get 10k, for 20,000, you will get 20k, and so on. So let's save this and run this. We got 0k, 10k, 20k, 30k, and so on. But here I'm seeing 10.0k, so we can even fix that using this function itself. Here I can write 0 and I'll write 0.0f so that I can get only the integer values. So I'm going to save it and run this. Here you can see I got 0, 10k, 20k, 30k, and so on. So using this func formatter, I was able to perform a complicated logic on the tick value so that I can get my desired tick label as a string. So let's move on to another important tick formatter, which is a date formatter. Using the date formatter, we can format the datetime labels of a matplotlib axis. So let's take this example, and here I'm going to import matplotlib dot dates as mdates. I'm going to import these three modules. So let's take an x and y values for our example. So these are the x and y values we are taking. So today is dt.datetime.today. So for that, I'm going to import the datetime module also. So import datetime as dt. I'm storing a variable called today, which is the now time, and I'm going to set the number of days as 9, and I'm creating an array called x, which contains 9 dates from today to previous 9 days. So let me try to run this and show you how x looks like. So what is the x values we are plotting? You can see that. I'm going to run this. Here you can see my x values are date time values, and those are like today, yesterday, day before yesterday, till 9 days, right? So these are the x values and these are the y values. So let's try to plot this without any formatters in matplotlib. So first I'm going to create the figure and axis handles, and then I'm going to plot the x and y values, and then I'm going to show the plot. Let's try to save it and run this. So here you can see I got the dates formatted already in my matplotlib. But if it is not your requirement, if you want your dates to be formatted as per your requirement, which is not the default format, then you can use the date formatter utility provided by matplotlib. So now if I want to change the format of x-axis, I can do ax.xaxis dot set major formatter, and here I'm going to write plt dot func formatter, and in the func formatter I'm going to write mdates dot date formatter, and here I'm going to write the date format string, which can be used to display the date labels. So if you want to write only the date and the month name, I can write percentage d dash percentage b. So basically it's the date and month in letters. So let me try to save it and run this. You can see I've plotted custom date format on the matplotlib x-axis using this date formatter. I've written only the date and month. So this way, using date formatter and func formatter, you can control how your dates are being displayed on the axis. So that's it about date formatter. And there is another formatter called null formatter. So if you want to hide your axis label, just write the major formatter and minor formatter of each axis as null formatter. It's really easy, guys. Let's try to implement this. What you just write is ax.xaxis.setMajorFormatter as plt dot null formatter, and then you write it for y-axis also, so you can write the y-axis dot set major formatter as plt dot null formatter, and the same way you just set this null formatter for minor axis also. You write ax dot x-axis dot minor formatter as null formatter, and the same way plt dot y-axis dot set minor formatter also null formatter, so that you can completely wipe out the labels on the axis. So if I just save it and run this, you can see you can only see the ticks and your labels are missing. This might be a requirement in some of our use cases. If you want to also remove the ticks, you have to use the plt.null locator. Let's try that also. I'm going to copy and paste this here, and instead of formatter, I'm going to replace it with locator. So what I did was, even I kept the locators as null locators. So let me just save it and run this. You know, you don't need the formatter anymore because you didn't make the ticks at all. So you don't need to use the formatters anyways. So let me just save it and run this. Now I got a clean axis without any ticks also. So you can use the null locator to completely hide the ticks and labels. But if you want to hide only labels, then you can use the null formatter. So let me show you again. If you want to hide only the labels, you can use a null formatter. So if you want to save this and run this, you can see I was able to display the ticks but hide the labels, because I'm using the null formatter for the format of labels. So the next formatter we're going to use is the fixed formatter. So generally fixed formatter is used as the fixed locator, otherwise you can't control how the tick labels are going to be displayed. So here's the example. So here I'm going to use the x-axis dot set major locator as my fixed locations, and since I know what are the locations are, I can give this fixed formatter with the fixed labels. So what I'm doing is I'm fixing where the ticks are going to be, and I'm fixing what are the names of the ticks. So generally people use fixed formatter along with fixed locator, guys. So this is a summary of various locators you can find in Matplotlib, and you have beautiful examples also, so that how can you use those formatters. You can see I've created a blog post on formatting axis tick labels using tick formatters in Matplotlib. I have even given the source code so that you can copy paste and practice it in your own computer. So be sure to check out the link of this blog post in the description of this video. Hope you like this video, guys. Thank you for watching.